The Ghana Woodball Federation held its annual general congress at Namirembe Resource Center in Menga, attended by delegates from the 42 member clubs. During the annual general congress, NCS Assistant General Secretary David Katende sounded a warning on federations which have failed in financial management as well as understanding the importance of accountability.
I want to take this opportunity to, first of all, inform the public that the government is very serious on the issues of accountability in the sports federations, and we would want to caution the various federations to take this seriously. As government, this is our key benchmarks for assessing federations, and it is not just merely a key benchmark, but it's a provision of the law, the legal frameworks that govern sport in this country. It is not optional. All national sports leaders and federations are required by law to account for government resources that they have received on behalf of Ugandans to run sports. We therefore request that the leaders comply with this provision.
Following misunderstandings between NCS and Uganda Netball Federation over accountability issues, Katende added a voice that all federations should get prepared assessment.
Is taking keener interest to follow up on the monies that has extended federations, and don't get surprised that in one of these days you may be visited by that executive arm of government, officials from the office of the Auditor General, trying to come and follow up on the monies that were extended to you. We request you to give them maximum cooperation, because this is done in the best interest of all Ugandans.
The President, Uganda Woodball Federation, Paul Mark Kayongo, however, welcomed the idea of tight assessment. The members approved the 2023 budget to a tune of 3.6 Uganda billion shillings, while the President noted that more focus is on constructing a permanent home.
As far as the woodball development project infrastructure, as I have reported in this Congress today, it is moving step by step, because it is a big project, and we saw it very fitting not to jump any essential stage. We had to consult at every level of our key stakeholders, including the National Council of Sports, Minister of Education and Sports, and eventually the project was referred to His Excellency, who gave a directive for further progress of the project. So where it is in the hands of the ministry in charge of the funding to see that the project can get the funds to stand as strategically planned.
The Federation members ushered in 10 new members, including Luengo Woodball Association, University of Chisubi, among others. The season is set to kickstart on 19th of this month with a corporate woodball circuit and Moves Playground in Nakawa.